Before I go into that building and start my day, I always like to take a quiet moment to prepare myself.
Victor! Dude, what did I say about singing and dancing?
It's not okay unless you do it as a group! I've been watching. Fine, I'll play some of that rocks.
As a third year resident, you know everyone so well, you can practically speak for them. For instance, it's 7 a.m., you're late. How was last night?
Have fun.
Good luck with all that.
All right. Rolling through CCU, saving lives, buddy.
How was your night?
Formal.
Five consults. Five holds.
You want me to do five consults and five holds?
This whole black cloud thing's real.
Yes.
Victor! You're walking into admission. Fuck.
See, things don't change around here.
No.
By the way, Dr. Ping is gonna call you.
Like Nurse Ahmad, inducing palpitations in Sim.
Code Blue, Sim Lab.
Corinne, sir, chest compressions. Dan, beg the patient. Nurse Ahmad, can you get Epi for the patient?
I don't think Epi is allowed on general medicine floors.
No, we need to give Epi. The patient's currently dead.
I don't think by policy I'm allowed to give Epi on general medicine floors.
Can we please do it this time?
Excuse me. Are you certified for CPR?
Yes.
I have to check on new innovations. Can you wait?
No, I can't stop CPR.
Okay, I'm going to have to call the nurse manager about this.
Where's anesthesia?
Okay, I brought the epinephrine.
Okay, nasal intubation. Perfect, let's give the epi.
There's no IV access.
We're having to spend long hours treating complex patients in clinic.
Hi, Mr. Shady, I'm Dr. Abelis. How can I help you today?
You can help by addressing my pain. Doctor, I have pain in my shoulders, my knees, but especially my pinky. I mean, it's getting excruciating.
You told me a lot about your pain today, and I understand that's very, very uncomfortable.
Correct.
The first line for fibromyalgia is actually some over-the-counter medication like Tylenol and ibuprofen. What do you think about that?
Whoa. Let's take it back a notch. I think the last doctor tried prescribing me ibuprofen, and I had a severe allergy.
I see. At this clinic, actually, for musculoskeletal pain without any trauma evidence, I think we recommend some physical therapy. What do you think?
But you know, there's one medication I think they use it. It's like one of those light pain meds they've given to me in the past in the ED, and it worked right away. I mean, the pain went away immediately, and I think it's called Derlordid.
I can safely say that everyone here is going to say no to your dialogue.
Well, that's not good enough!
Meanwhile, Andrew's probably on a flight to Italy, or first class to Japan, or Laos, or Cambodia, or Portugal. The only difference about third year is nothing takes you by surprise. Okay, maybe small surprises, but nothing big.
So Mr. Levitt is a 67-year-old male. He's had two GI bleeds in the past that were scoped, and GI didn't really find anything, so he's back with another GI bleed. He's hemodynamically stable, but he's gotten two units, so we're going to move him to the floors. Hi, Mr. Levitt. This is Dr. Garcia. He's going to do your admission.
Gotta level with me, man. What's going on?
Oh, good Lord. I have no idea. Just do what all good doctors do in this situation.
Yeah, I got a page.
What's going on with that med student?
He's learning.
I can't do this all on my own. No, I know I'm no Superman. I'm no Superman.
All right, Victoria, I need your help.
Hey, what's up?
So I got this guy downstairs and I don't really know what to do.
What's he here for?
Some 56-year-old guy coming in with abdominal pain.
Hey, hold up. I gotta go, Victor. Sorry. You're on your own. I'll see you later.
Oh, I'll go ask Kerm and James.
You were saying your son thinks Dr. Weissman is Captain America?
Yeah, except he's confused because he says that Dr. Weissman doesn't have a suit.
Oh, yes. Oh wow. Weissman just says daddy's going to the hospital.
Okay, never mind. Walk away slowly. Really. Guess I'll go ask the Chiefs.
Thank you so much for coming in, Bari. I have some really unfortunate news. Due to unforeseen circumstances, you're going to have to cover MAR for the next 3 months.
Why?
Let me really break it down for you. So, you see the highlighting for your sticker? So it matches the highlighting that I put on the MedRes schedule where I put you in for 3 months. So Talal's also does, but he can't really cover just because, you know, Team B is a lot of patients, it's a high turnover, he's got new interns, and you're not gonna really be able to do that, especially when you're coming off of nights, you've got a post-call day. Then, you know, Krish, but he's on clinic, so he would be an option too, because the highlighting matches. And, he would be in the same location, but it's still not going to really work out that well because he's got some continuity with his patients in clinic. And you could technically cover his clinic, but that wouldn't work out that well because you guys have your two different packs and two different attendings that you're precepting with. So that's not going to really work out that well either. Good?
I'm not following.
Aria, have a seat. We know getting news like this isn't easy, but we want to make sure you understand this is not a reflection of anything about your performance as a resident. It's not a punishment. We love working with you. You've always done a great job. And it's just logistical details why we're asking you to cover, okay?
But why?
Hey, can I ask you guys a question or something?
Hey, Victor, look who it is.
All right, so this patient upstairs, and I don't really know what's going on or what I should do with him. And that's not even helping me out.
Okay, what's the question?
So he's got like this abdominal pain and like potential blood diarrhea. I don't even know what to do next.
Abdominal pain and bloody diarrhea?
Yeah.
I don't really know what I would do, but here's a paper on something totally different I encourage you to read. Your question, why don't you go ask Dr. Lane? I got a meeting to go to.
There are times in residency when things just don't line up properly.
Hello, patient. My name is Dr. Ping. What seems to be the issue today?
I have an earache. Oh, an earache. I've dealt with this before. Nurse, we need a stat EKG now! Troponins times 5.
But it's just my ear.
Please take off your pants.
Are you sure this is necessary, doctor?
I am.
Left or the right side?
Both.
Okay.
All right, well, now that I've had a look at you, I'm going to admit you to the hospital. You have some abnormal markers. Let me just make some phone calls here. You're not doing anything now.
I think I have a dinner appointment.
It's okay. Hi, is this the MAR?
Hi, yes, this is the MAR.
Dr. Ping, I'm admitting a patient to you. I need a team now, please.
Why is the patient coming in?
The problem, I guess, you know, he's got troponins, so he's coming into the hospital, okay?
I don't even know what his symptoms are. How high was the troponin?
Yeah, the trope level, it's not important. His symptoms not important. Just, you know, he's got troponins. Come to the hospital. Please give me a team.
Sometimes to get through it all, you look at the person beside you and you're glad you're not her. Well, that reminded me, I still don't know what's going on with Mr. Levitt. I gotta go check in on him and keep up his spirits.
Hey, how you doing, sir?
Positively constipated with fear and worry and an unrelenting pain. Good.
Okay, great.
What am I gonna do? There's nothing wrong with needing your friends to take care of someone.
Hey man, I got help.
Perfect, so we're gonna do, you guys work on the echo and I'm gonna grab the attendings and then we'll meet together at CAT scan and talk about what we're gonna do.
Sounds good.
Awesome. Let's do it.
Medicine is a team game after all. Hi, Dr. Lane, Dr. Aang, Dr. Kranz, Dr. Gulsaran, Dr. Abdullah.
So, Victor, what's up?
Oh, I just need your help trying to figure out what's going on with this patient downstairs.
We're kind of in a meeting right now. Can it wait?
Yeah, we can meet up later.
How's 12 o'clock?
Perfect.
I'll see you then.
Great.
I don't know how you're going to get cardiology to a stat bedside.
Oh, child, please. I got this. Hello?
Cardiology.
Yeah, I need a stat echo for this patient at bedside.
Why? What's going on?
Well...
That doesn't meet criteria!
I didn't even say anything yet. It's Kervin, by the way.
Oh, Kervin? Oh, hey! Okay, that's fine. I'll be there. Bye.
Alright, thank you.
Got the echo.
What? How?
Unfortunately, we ran into a brick wall.
Oh, hey, Victor.
Hey, guys, did the echo?
Oh, yeah, we did.
Oh, great.
Did you talk to the attending?
Dude.
Why?
Oh, thanks for coming in. I know you're the only one on tonight. We need to get the CT scan to rule out obstruction.
You called me in to do a CAT scan that could have waited. Guess what? Not happening.
Sir.
Your patient is 40 people down the list. And there are no cutscenes. These are my machines. Mine.
Whose machines?
They're my machines.
How is that helpful?
They're my machines.
Guys, I got this.
They're my machine. My
3,
machine.
My 2,
machine. My
1.
My machine. My machine. My machine. Hello?
Hi, it's Dr. Weissman.
Why, hello, sir. All right, bring the patient down.
Hello?
It feels good to work as a team, so we can finally look at Mr. Levitt in the face and tell him...
I still don't know what's going on with this patient.
All right, so what do you guys know so far?
Echo ruled out mitral regurg.
The CAT scan's unremarkable.
Think, come on, guys, you know this.
Hemisuccus pancreaticus.
You got it.
Like I said, once you get to third year, there aren't many surprises.
Except when you realize you graduate tomorrow, and you realize it's the end. We should consider ourselves lucky, even if we only occasionally get to make someone, really anyone, feel a little better. And then after all that, it's really all about the people that we let into our lives.
As I rounded the corner, they all came at me in a wave of shared experiences.
I'm thankful for so many friendly people.
The support, camaraderie, and friendship from the amazing people in our program.
Dr. Lane and 4 weeks of vacation a year.
For making me a better doctor.
Dr. Lane!
Also Dr. Lane.
All the amazing friends I made.
All of our mentors.
For the amazing friendship.
Yep, I love you guys.
Walks to Stone and Soup.
Golden weekends.
Academic Wednesday lunches.
My wife, friends, and Starbucks.
Lifelong relationships.
For all my co-residents and attendings.
For all the great friends.
Dr. Lane and all the friends.
All the rewarding experiences and the snacks.
All the amazing friendships I made.
Neshoah. For all the great faculty.
My friends and my wife.
My wife and my friends.
The people I've met and the influences they've left on me.
The original AmFam.
All the residents. Without them, we wouldn't get through it.
I'm thankful for all these guys.
See you, bro.
Even though it felt warm and safe, I knew it had to end. It's never good to live in the past too long. As for the future, it didn't seem too scary anymore.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah. Look at your phone.
I got a page.
By the way, Dr. Ping is going to call you.
About what?
I didn't know.
Well, then close your eyes and know the words are coming from my heart. And then if you can remember, oh, keep smiling, keep shining.
Wait, you actually
did
this?
Yeah. No.
The CAT scan's negative. The CAT scan's unremarkable. For sure. That's what friends are for.
For good times and bad times. I still don't know what's going on with this patient.
It's never the gel!
You think you're gonna be a future sim chief?
And you can walk away.
I don't wanna be like.
Thanks for graduating without us.
Share the night, it goes on.